If you followed our 2008 Toyota Tacoma build, you probably remember when we installed a Fab Fours Premium Series front bumper. Well, the reason we have it off is because at the time we used a winch we already had sitting around that had a little bit of age to it. Well, after putting some off-road miles on the truck and having to use it, the winch finally bit the dust, so we decided to go ahead and upgrade it. One of the critical things you need on a truck is a good winch, so we're getting ready to actually take this thing to Easter Jeep Safari, and we want to make sure we got great recovery equipment for this Toyota and the Jeep playground. So we picked up this Warren VR10S. Now what this is a 10,000 pound winch, which does perfect if you're doing off the 1.5 times multiple for this off-road truck. So we've got plenty of pulling power, and we went with the synthetic rope option. That is the S portion of the 10. Why we picked the synthetic cable or rope, depending on how you want to say it, is we like how light it is and it's really easy to use. Sure, you have to be careful on more abrasive stuff and you have to maintain it a little bit more than you do cable, but overall for a daily driver, we like the weight savings, and again, it's very easy to use. A few other attributes of the VR10S is the fact that we have a removable control box. So if it doesn't clear in here, we can actually relocate this under the hood or route it somewhere else. Now, we have just enough room to bolt it in there, so we'll be able to get in through one of these windows to access the plug-in and run it like usual, so it's not going to be an issue for this particular bumper, but it is an extremely nice feature. It took us about 30 minutes to get the bumper removed and the old winch out. Since Warren sends the VR10S pre-wired, all we had to do was attach it to the bumper, install the hook, and wire the positive and negative leads to the battery. While we originally set out to the beach to do some suspension fine-tuning and a little relaxing, we quickly found we'd be using our winch a lot faster than we thought. Thankfully, this wouldn't be for us but to recover a Land Rover that was completely buried in the sand. Though we had to reposition a time or two to get it safely out, we were able to do so with ease and with a quick line speed. We're sure we'll have more opportunities to test out our VR10S in our upcoming trip to Moab, Utah for the 52nd annual Easter Jeep Safari. But until then, be sure to visit us at drivingline.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel to see our latest adventures.